I've got a confession. Are you listening? I'm absolutely awful at DIY. Even if I had the right tools, which I wouldn't because I'm awful at DIY, so why would I want the tools? But even if I did have the tools, I haven't got a clue how to use them. Now that's DIY. I can get away with that. But maybe like me, you sometimes have challenges in life, situations that come up, and you're thinking, what tools do I need to deal with this challenge and to help me build a better life? Well, that's what this video is all about. I wrote a book many, many years ago called S.U.M.O, Shut Up and Move On. And in that book, I talk about 7 questions to help you S.U.M.O. So here's what I'd like you to do right now. Think of an issue or a challenge that's going on in your world right now, maybe in your work or perhaps in your personal life. And you sit back and listen to these 7 questions and see how they can help you deal with that challenge. Here's the first question. Where is this issue on a scale of 1 to 10? In brackets, where 10 equals death. Get a bit of perspective. Question 2. How important will this be in 6 months' time? Maybe it's a big issue now, but let's just step back and get a bigger picture. Question 3. Is my response appropriate and effective? Just reflect for a moment and think, is the way I'm dealing with this situation giving me the best outcome? Because if it isn't, change your response. Is your response appropriate and effective? Question 4. How can I influence or improve the situation? Notice it's influence or improve, not transform it overnight necessarily. But what could you do to influence or improve the situation? Maybe you need to ask somebody for some support or for their advice or for their wisdom. But focus on that 4th question. How can I influence or improve the situation? Question 5. What can I learn from this? You know, life has many lessons to teach us, but sometimes we just see them as a problem to bat away rather than as something to actually think, you know what, this could teach me something. So ask yourself that question. What can I learn from this? Question 6. What would I do differently next time? You know, you can't manage history. Maybe you made a mistake, you regret what you did. It happens. But faced with that scenario again in the future, ask yourself, so what would I do differently next time? And question 7, what can I find that is positive in this situation? You know, your brain helps you find what you're looking for. And sometimes we can feel really overwhelmed by the problem and the situation and the challenge, lose total perspective and become even demoralized. But when you say to yourself, okay, what can I find that's positive in this situation? Invariably, you'll find something. So maybe like me, you're not great at DIY. But we're not talking about building a house or fitting a kitchen. We're talking about enjoying a better life, enjoying a great life. And those 7 questions can be a brilliant tool to help you do so. Here they are again. Scale of 1 to 10, where 10's death, where is it? How important will this be in 6 months' time? Is my response appropriate and effective? How can I influence or improve the situation? What can I learn from this? What would I do differently next time? And what can I find that is positive in this situation? Hi guys, if you found those 7 questions helpful, remember they are lifted, with my permission because I wrote the book, from this book, S.U.M.O, Shut Up and Move On. You can find the details of how to access this via Amazon in the link below. And those 7 questions I talked about, just go along to my website, thesumoguy.com. Go to the downloads page. You can download the 7 questions. Really hope this helps you. Remember then, it's thesumoguy.com for more information.